Hi, I am Sayyed Rashid. You are watching Ahlewad High School and Junior College YouTube channel. Welcome to my video to all students as well as viewers. Today, we are continuing our physical science like physics, class 11th or inter first year, we can say. Chapter number 10, mechanical properties of solid. And we are continuing or we are starting our part number 2. In part number 1, we have come across few things with us. Now, we will going to learn few things in this part. As you can see, already I wrote on board. And we have few topics with us like details of modulus, what is modulus and how many types of modulus are there, and I am going to show you one table in that I will going to show like Young's modulus, elastic limit and tensile strength of some materials. So let us start our class. Modulus of elasticity. What is modulus of elasticity? It is defined as the ratio of stress to strength within the elastic limit. As you can see by the definition itself, modulus of elasticity is nothing but it is a ratio of stress by strength. But here again we have one condition with us. The condition is nothing but within the elastic limit, and this is called as modulus of elasticity. Now that is modulus of elasticity K. Here K is nothing but we can consider as modulus of elasticity, like stress by strength. Simple. You can remember by reading itself. If you read once or twice, automatically it will be captured by you. Young's modulus. How many types of modulus we have with us? Usually we have many types of modulus, but in our inter first year we will going to learn three types of modulus, like Young's modulus, bulk modulus and shear modulus. So you can see YOUNGS, Young's modulus. It is defined as the ratio of longitudinal stress to longitudinal strength within the elastic limit. Here stress is denoted by sigma. We will call this symbol as sigma, whereas this symbol is nothing but epsilon strength. So you can see the formula also. Young's modulus y is equals to sigma like by epsilon. So which this is second definition, like Young's modulus. Now bulk modulus. Bulk modulus, it is defined as the ratio of hydraulic stress to hydraulic strength within the elastic limit. Bulk modulus, here you can see that modulus and bulk modulus both are denoted by K itself, but we have difference in the formula and writing thing. Here we can see that K is equals to P divided by delta V, and here we are taking delta V as negative, like minus delta V by V. So this is the bulk modulus. Next we have like shear modulus. It is defined as the ratio of shear stress, like sigma we are writing S, to shear strength theta within elastic limit. Shear modulus G, here we are just supposing this as G is equals to sigma S by delta. So this is the what is modulus and types of modulus. You need to it might ask you in examination like 4 marks, what is modulus of elasticity, how many types of modulus are there, define them. Just it will ask you simple like this question only, and you can just copy down this and you will get 4 marks. And for BIPC student needs and MPC student, JEE means MCET, whatever you are going to competitive examination, you need to remember these formulas like stress by strength and sigma by epsilon, P by minus like delta V by V, whereas G is equals to sigma S by delta. It will work in our competitive examination for numerical part. Now the time to copy, and we don't have much to explain this definition. This has simple definition, you can remember easily and you can understood too. So now the time to copy down which is written on board. Hope you have copied this definition. We have one more small definition with us, you can see on the board. Poisson's ratio. It is defined as the ratio of lateral strength to the longitudinal strength. Poisson's ratio, here mu is equals to lateral strength by longitudinal strength. This is also a small definition, you can remember, and you can write here only. I'm just standing few seconds here. You can just pause the video and copy down this also. As you can see the table on your screen, that is Young's modulus, elastic limit and tensile strength of some material. As you can see, there are materials like aluminium, copper, iron, steel, bone. Here, bone is like we can say tensile compression. So, you can see that Young's modulus, elastic limit, tensile strength. So, for aluminium, we have Young's modulus like 70, elastic limit like 80, and tensile strength as 20. Whereas copper consists of 120 as Young's modulus, elastic limit as 20, whereas tensile strength is 40. Same you can see remaining things also, and this is in the unit of Newton per meter square, as you can see. And for Young's modulus, and before Newton's per meter square, we have N2 also. That is Young's modulus. Usually, like the Young's modulus, it might ask you in examination 2 marks, what is the value of Young's modulus of aluminium. So you need to write the Young's modulus value of aluminium is 70 into 10 power 9 Newton per meter square. Like that you have to write. So in competitive examination also it might ask like what is the value of like elastic limit of iron. So it may give you multiple options. In that multiple options you need to just select like 17 into 10 power of 7 Newton per meter square. So this is one of the important table you need to go through. You can write and remember also. So this is somewhat details about our modulus. So this box which I displayed just now on your screen, write down that box and try to make few questions and answer from that box itself. Now we have few important things with us, like what is the units and dimension of stress, that means unit unit. Hope you have saw the table. Make sure write the table in your books and try to make few questions and answers from that table itself. Now we will going to learn like units and dimensions of stress. Okay, what is units and dimension? Do you remember chapter number 2 of our like inter first year physics? Units and dimension of stress, stress. Okay, so here we know the formula for stress. What is the formula for stress, all the student and viewers? Like force by area. Here force is nothing but restoring force, we have to say. Now what is the SI unit for force? Okay, for SI unit of force is nothing but N. Whereas what is the SI unit of like area? We are taking SI unit of area as meter square. Okay, now dimension formula, what will be the dimension formula for that? So you can see here the dimension formula for that is dimensions formula, formula formula for stress. Okay, str st, what is the spelling of stress? stress. Okay, for stress, stress, stress. So here we can write like m power 1, l power 1 and t power minus 2. This is the dimension formula for stress. So you can see this is the dimension formula related to the stress, that stress is equals to force by area. If I want some elaboration, means I can write like stress, stress, stress is equals to force, okay, into like area minus 1, isn't it? Because I am just taking this upside. Then from this like force formula, area formula, we can derive this. And one more thing here, it is minus 1, like m power 1, l power minus 1 and t power minus 2. This is the dimension formula usually for stress. Whereas we have few dimension formulas related to like Young's modulus, modulus of rigidity, bulk modulus. These are the things I am going to place on your screen, you can go through. That's all about our today's session and today's class. We will going to continue our same like chapter, mechanical properties of solid, in our next session. You are watching Ahlebait High School and Junior College YouTube channel. I am Sayyed Rashid. Have a great time. Take care. Practice more than one time. Thank you.